Hello everyone. Today we will discuss about classification of fishes. So as we have already discussed about the general characteristics of fishes in previous videos, here fishes has been divided into three classes. First class is Placodermy, second is Chondrichthyes, and third is Osteichthyes. Let us recall that the most important and unique character of fishes is presence of fins as locomotory organ. But here the classification depends on the presence of endoskeleton that may be bony or cartilaginous. And Placodermy is group of fishes that has been extinct, whereas Chondrichthyes and Osteichthyes are fishes that live in the present world. So first we will discuss about Placodermy. The most important character of the class Placodermy is the presence of bony armor, or we can say plate skin. Their skin is made of plate or bony armor. Jaws are present, means they are the first jawed vertebrates, and as we already said that it is an extinct class, means all the members have been extinct. There are two orders in this class. First is Arthrodiriformes and second is Antiarchiformes. Arthrodiriformes, the armor of head and trunk is with movable joints, means the armor is jointed and the joints are movable. These are marine animals, and the example is Dinictis. In Antiarchiformes, pectoral fins are long, they are freshwater animals, and the example is Pterichthyes. Next. Second class of fishes is class Chondrichthyes, which are also known as cartilaginous fishes due to the presence of cartilaginous endoskeleton. This is also divided into two subclasses. First subclass is Salishae and the second subclass is Holocephali. Salishae is divided into two orders. Salishae represents the Chondrichthyes class, and the other subclass Holocephali is an with some exceptions or some exceptional characters which are not of Chondrichthyes. So the second subclass Holocephali is recognized. In subclass Salishae, order Squaliformes is also known as Pleurotremata, means as the name indicates that gill slits are lateral, pleuro means lateral, and they are 5 to 7 pairs. Spiracle is small, and the example is Scoliodon or dogfish, which is commonly studied in UG to represent the vertebrates. Fishes. Then the second order of class subclass Salishae is Rasiformes, that is also known as Hypotremata, and the body is dorsoventrally flattened. There are 5 pairs of gill slits, that is ventral, so the name is Hypotremata. Hypo means ventral. Then large pectoral fin and spiracle is also large, and the example is Trigon or stingray. Then the second subclass Holocephali, as we already said that it is with some exceptional characters which are not the characters of class Chondrichthyes, such as no spiracle means absence of spiracle, whereas spiracles is present in the cellage. Single gill opening on either side covered by fleshy operculum. So the operculum is present here and the tail is isocercal, single nasal opening, and the example is the famous Chimera or Hydrolagus. Next, the third class of fishes or pieces is Osteichthyes, that is known as bony fishes due to the presence of bony endoskeleton. This is also divided into two subclasses. First subclass is Sarcopterygii with two orders. The first order is Prosopterygii, and the characters of Prosopterygii is caudal fin with three lobes. It represents living fossils and also known as lobe-finned fishes due to the presence of three lobes in caudal fin. The common example is Letimelia, that is a living fossil, means a single genus present in a present era, which represent the order Prosopterygii. Then the second order of Sarcopterygii is Dipnoid, that is also known as lung fishes, and the tail is protocercal. They breathe on land by air bladder, which act as lungs. So the presence of air bladder is an important character in lung fishes, which act as lungs. And the example is Protopterus, which is an African lungfish. And another example may be Lepidosiren, that is an American lungfish. And the next example is Neoceratodus, that is an African lungfish. Next, the second subclass of class Osteichthyes is Actinopterygii with three superorders. The first superorder is Chondrosti with two orders. Chondrosti is the name indicated, the endoskeleton is of cartilaginous. Well, they are included in bony fishes, Osteichthyes, but the endoskeleton is cartilaginous, so they are included under the superorder Chondrosti due to the presence of cartilaginous endoskeleton. The first order is Polypteriformis. The character is rhomboid ganoid scales, dorsal fin of 8 or more finlets. The example is Polypterus or Bichir. The second order is Accipensoriformis, and they are scaleless barbels on ventral side below mouth. An example is Accipenser or Sturgeon. Then the second superorder of Actinopterygii is Holosti, that is with two orders, order Amiformis and Semiontiformis. Amiformis with snout rounded, long dorsal fin and cycloid scales, and the example is Amia or bow fin. The second order Semionotiformis, that is with snout and body elongated, ganoid scales are present. Example is Lepidosteus or Garpi. So these are the second two orders, superorders, and now the last superorder, that is Teleosti of Osteichthyes, that include 15 orders. Here we will mention the name of the orders. First, Scopeliformis, then second, Syngnathiformis, third, Symbranchiformis, fourth, Scorpeniformis, fifth, Rupiformis, sixth, Cypriniformis, seventh, Belloniformis, eighth, Ophiocephaliformis, 9th Astaxanthellipharmus, 10th Pleuronectiphermes, 11th Perciformes, 12th Anguilliformes, 13th Tetraodontiformes, 4th Echiniformes, and 5th Lophiformes. So this is all about the outline classification of fishes, and thank you very much.